In the last few months, Interior Secretary Dr. Fred Matiang'i has sought to distinguish and endear himself to his bosses by issuing threats to opposition leaders, and I want to say NASA leaders, because we no longer are opposition leaders, and cracking down hard on even killing NASA supporters. Dr. Matiang'i must be thinking he is being innovative and original as he flaunts imaginary powers and basks in imaginary greatness. But Dr. Matiang'i may not know it, is actually on a familiar and beaten path, the path of threats, arrests, killings, and psychophancy that Matiang'i is on was the one chosen by the likes of the late Hezekiah Oyugi, Okiki Amayo, George Saitoti, Joseph Olelenku, and Joseph Nkaiseri, among others. Kenya has had an unfair share of politicians who thought psychophancy and closeness to the presidency was enough insurance against the excesses they defended. They found out late, or never did at all, because the system they eloquently defended eventually molded. Tom Joseph Oweya was Jomo Kenyatta's right-hand man, as we all know. Those of us who are not born then could have read in the history books that he was President Jomo Kenyatta's right-hand man. He stood with Kenyatta against Kenyatta's perceived enemies. He engineered changes to the constitution to protect Kenyatta. Remember, he's the one who even initiated a move to split the vice presidents of this country into eight. He devised political schemes to cut Kenyatta's opponents to size. He was master of ceremonies at independence celebrations where Kenyatta was declared prime minister. Then Kenyatta came for him. The point we wish to make to Dr. Matiang'i is better men than you, more competent ministers than you, have stood the very steps of Harambee House, where you stand today, to issue threats. We were not scared then. Kenyans were not scared then. They have never been scared. We will not be scared now. And Dr. Matiang'i has come and shall go in infamy, as many of his predecessors have. Dr. Matiang'i must work to secure Kenyans by upholding the constitution and not be a hatchet man for a dictatorial regime out to use security forces to intimidate and even eliminate political opponents. In the meantime, we call on our supporters not to allow fear to enter their hearts. At moments like this, the temptation is there that you may feel subdued, you may feel intimidated, you may feel threatened. But we want to urge our supporters across the country, and we are the majority in this country. NASA has the majority of the supporters. We want to appeal to them to stand firm. We wish to tell our people, you have nothing to fear. You have not broken any law.